Hello everybody, my name is Stefan and the next 15 minutes I want to explain a little bit more about my organ, my Versi Atlantis organ, because I had so many questions about it from people that looked at my YouTube channel.
Let's have a look at this beautiful instrument. It was produced in 1994, but it still looks very recent. This Versi Atlantis organ was developed in Germany and was part of the famous Versi CD line. But what was this CD line? Where did it came from? And why is it sounding so good after almost 30 years? And how did it influence the fantastic instruments Versi is making today? Let's go back in time a little bit and look at the history of the instrument. It all started in 1969. When two brothers developed their first do-it-yourself organ kits. They lived in the German village Werlau in the district of Zimmern, and the first characters of these names formed the brand name Versi. In the 60s, electronic do-it-yourself kits for radio receivers and other electronic equipment were quite common in Europe. Böhm was the first to do this in Germany for electronic organs, but Versi followed with their first series of organs, of which the W248S model was the most popular, not in the least because Klaus Wunderlich added this to his Hammond and Lowry setup. With a new tone generation system and several patented inventions, the second analog series was introduced around 1976. A microprocessor-based sound computer and several high-end analog rhythm units made the organs complete. The Helios and the three-manual Galaxis organ were the most popular and the dream of many musicians. It must be around this period that the typical Versi sound was born, especially the fact that the tone generator provided three important analog waveforms was unique for that time. The sine wave was necessary for the organ sound, the sawtooth and pulse were necessary to emulate the orchestral sounds as close as possible with analog technology. But it was certainly the phase vibrato, called Versi voice, that created the typical analog organ and string sounds. The first real steps in the digital world were set with the CX2 digital rhythm unit and the Comet organ. The Comet still had analog tone generation but was digitally controlled. It was developed to provide a cheaper instrument with a lot of possibilities. However, except for the famous Comet guitar, the sound was far away from the unique sound of the Helios or Galaxis. So the model was only produced for a few years. But then in 1986, Versi surprised and impressed friends and enemies with their new DX series, their first organs with digital tone generation. The most popular models here were the Alpha, Beta and Delta. All the models were equipped with a lot of features which were very modern for that time. MIDI, of course, but also data saving on tape recorder, RS-232 interface for connection with computer, and so on. The whole tone generation system with master and slave processors, with one processor and digital analog converter for each produced tone, was patented and ahead of its time. Only very expensive studio synthesizer systems like the Synclavier or the PPG Wave had similar electronic structures. The tone generation was based on 8-bit wavetables, but at the end there was analog processing, like a voltage-controlled filter based on the popular SSM chip, and of course the famous Versi voice, the analog phase vibrator. The first digital series in 8-bit technology was a good test and exercise to go to the real stuff. A digital organ in complete 16-bit technology. The introduction of the Versi Spectra on the Frankfurter Music Fair was the biggest talk of the fair. The CD line refers to the 16-bit technology that was then used in compact disc systems. The principle was similar to that of the first digital series. However, now everything was at least in 16-bit technology. The new possibilities of memory cards, DSP chips, bigger wave memory were fully used. Again, the unique sound was finished with analog circuitry, an analog filter for nice brass and synth sounds, and now even two VersiVoice systems for more possibilities with rotor and string effects on all the manuals. The Spectra was the first model, but resulted in a complete series. And in 1989, more than a decade after the Galaxis, another three-manual Versi organ was introduced, the Atlantis. The specific design in white polish was so impressive and ahead of its time that still today in 2021, it is a design piece in every living room. In the beginning of the 90s, it came also available in high-end black polish. Only one of these instruments was made with chrome silver buttons and drawbars. And I'm happy to have that unique instrument in my collection. That's the one that you see and hear in all the YouTube films.
So far so good, but the moment the organ came on the market, it was not in the status it is today. Two very important extensions were added afterwards. One was the Golden Gate module, and the other was the OX7 drawbar module. Let's have a look where this is coming from.
For that, we have to go back to the next chapter in Versi history. After the development of the CD line, the first Versi digital piano was created. A complete new technology was used for the sampling of a Steinway grand piano, and the compression algorithms to put in the memory chips were unique. The real sample synthesis was now introduced in the Versi instruments. Since the electronic components became so small and ASIC transputer chips were used, it was the end of the do-it-yourself kits of Versi. In 1991, I did my engineering master thesis at the Versi R&D department in Halsenbach, and I could take part in the development of this fantastic technology. In 1992, the sampling technology of this groundbreaking digital piano was used to provide not only sampled piano sounds, but a complete range of sampled orchestral sounds as an extension to the CD line. This extension was called Lifestyle, and this Lifestyle formed then the basis of the Versi Pegasus keyboard. The Pegasus was the very first musical instrument worldwide with a touchscreen, and incorporated a complete 16-track MIDI sequencer, sound editing and layering, floppy disk, hard disk, and many more. The whole Pegasus technology could now be added to the CD line again, to have an up-to-date instrument. This extension was called the Golden Gate. As such, the CD line instruments were now equipped with a touchscreen, hard disk, floppy disk, and all the new modern technology. A few years later, and after some financial problems of the Versi company, the first instrument based on virtual modeling was introduced. It was the OX7 drawbar module. The module was designed to emulate the most famous Hammond organ sounds, such as the B3 or the H100. And again, this module could be retrofitted into the Atlantis organ. So what makes my Atlantis organ so unique is the mix of all these technologies that Versi used during its history up to 1998. Analog technology for filtering and VersiVoice phase vibrato, digital wavetable synthesis of the CD line, real sampling of the Golden Gate, and virtual modeling technology to emulate the best Hammond sounds. It was the highlight moment in Versi history, not only in terms of musical possibilities and sounds, but also in terms of electronics technology. But of course, the history of Versi did not end here. On the other hand, as from 1999, a complete new approach was made to the organ development. With the introduction of the OpenArt system, the whole Versi organ was now based on a Windows computer. This opened unlimited possibilities, and again the instruments were far ahead of their time. The only thing that rested from the CD line period was the design of the furniture of the Atlantis. After all, this unique design was reused for the top line instrument of the new OAS line, the Versi Louvre. And it didn't stop there. The OAS concept was then updated to OAX in 2015 with an evolved PC and audio board configuration, and of course a totally new concept and software. The actual OAX instruments are really super music workstations with almost unlimited possibilities. The integration of VST virtual instruments is unique in the music world. And again, several good things of the Atlantis period are used. The design of the top model Pergamon is still based on the furniture design of the White Atlantis. And the OX7 drawbar virtual modeling module is now integrated as a software instrument. Instruments ready for this next decade.
I hope you enjoyed the explanation, but of course you can enjoy the instrument the most if you listen to it, so please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I post a song every week and there you can discover more of the sounds of the instruments. Thank you, have a nice day and bye. Thank you.